848 WABC. Talk with Bernie and Sid in the morning right now. 800-848-9222. Where New York comes to talk. 77 WABC.
Okay, Tri-State, it is our song of the week. Sponsored by Hooters on 33rd Street and 7th Avenue. Bruce, baby, he's the best. Check this out.
I got so down and out in Frisco.
This is good.
Tired of the pills and the rain.
What's the name of this song, Burn?
I picked up headed for the sunshine.
Tucson Train.
I left a good thing behind.
You do it, boss. I'm going to go see you in concert soon. This announces new concert tour. Bruce back on the road. Bruce Springsteen.
This is from his new album, Western Stars, which drops June 14th.
All righty.
Hey, listen, we got talking about June 14th, summer on the way, and we got a couple of softball games coming up. July 24th, of course, against Channel 5 at MCU Park, raising money for Maimonides Hospital. Our dear friend Heshy Ogenbaum. We're going to play a couple of games this summer. We got another scheduled for the first Friday in August, also at MCU Park in Coney Island. And I met these guys a while back. I actually met them, believe it or not, Bern, during that wild election week is where I first met Steve. I met him at Russo's on the Bay and then saw him again at Aldo's Pizzeria, my good friend Anthony and Charlie Marino and all the guys, with Mark Molinaro the day of the election day.
I recall.
Right. And it turns out that Steve Sergiovanni and his friend Sal Anelli are both here today, and they're heavily involved with the Kiwanis Club. Their specific one is in Howard Beach, but they're all over New York, obviously. And they're raising money during this softball game and other efforts they do throughout the year. They get involved with this really great camp in upstate New York where they help out kids who otherwise may not have a place to go during the summer. So with that said, first of all, they brought in a whole bunch of food. Stella Dora for dessert. Really? Panianco Bakery on 3rd Avenue in Bay Ridge with bacon, egg, and cheese and veggie eggs and bagels and cream cheese. So not only does Steve and Sal come with an important message, but like Italians do, they come with great food. Thank you, gentlemen. How are you, boys?
No lie. Great. Thank you.
Thank you, Sid.
Thank you, Sid.
Steve, let's start with you. We had a chance to meet a couple of times in November. We've gotten very close since.
Yes.
We share a dear friend, along with Sal, Mike Sullivan, in common. A couple of great lunches.
Yes.
At Brennan and Carr in Brooklyn.
Yes.
Tell everybody, first of all, about the game we're going to play in August and why that game is important for the Kiwanis Club moving forward.
Okay. In August, we're going to be playing Sid and Friends, all-star team, at MCU Park. And all the money we raise to send children to camp.
Right.
Like you said, who otherwise might not have a place to go this summer. All the money, like I said, will be directly in supporting the children.
Right.
To bring them to the camp. Kiwanis is an organization that is looking after children. Help children.
Right.
And New York District, and we have Camp Kiwanis with the K up in Taborg, New York. And we have about 600 children that go there.
That's a lot.
That otherwise, that wouldn't, never see a stream.
Sure.
And Sal is the president of the foundation.
Yeah, I want to get this out. What's the trivia question I wanted to ask?
Okay, trivia question is, as there's a theme today.
Yeah.
Okay, number one, congratulations on becoming the Grand Marshal.
Thank you.
Okay. Stella Doro cookies.
Yes.
You know what's so important about Stella Doro cookies?
What is important about Stella Doro cookies, Steve?
They're pav.
Oh, they are kosher.
Yes, they're kosher.
Yes.
Now, just imagine, because I distribute these as a living. I'm sitting there, and I'm talking to a rabbi, and a rabbi's telling me, he goes, you don't know what's so important about this cookie? I says, no. I'm a guy that knows about macaroni, meatballs, and sausage. I don't know about anything else.
Right.
So he sat down. He says, you can eat this right after you have a meal.
That's right. That's true.
So, in honor of your being Grand Marshal,
thank you.
Brought you a basket of Stella Doro.
A lot of Stella Doro there, Steve.
Listen, your producer is looking at the Swiss fudge.
No,
so,
I know. No.
But anyway, this trivia question. Now,
that's very nice of you, though. By the way, thank you, Steve.
Nah, it's like he says, when you go to somebody's house,
you bring
a gift.
That's right. So, what is the question?
Okay, the question is: you just said on Friday, WPLJ closed down.
Right.
Growing up as a kid, Jim Carr. You know, Scott Shannon,
right.
DJs. What was the last song played on WABC before it went to all talk radio? Look at your phones.
I have no idea. Bernie, you want to take a guess?
Yes, I do. Let me see. The year was It was in the early 70s.
No.
No?
Even before that.
No, later.
Okay. No, the last song is Video Killed the Radio Star.
No. Last song was Starting Over by John Lennon.
Oh, wow.
And I remember because he just died.
Yeah.
And he got assassinated.
Great song.
I was in college.
Yeah.
And they made a big deal of it. And I just wanted to know what the last song was.
You just won. You get to keep those Stella Gold cookies.
No, I got enough of them. I don't need them. But anyway, let's talk about what we came here to talk about.
Thank you for that. Now, Sal, of course, Steve mentioned the camp. Upstate New York kids that ordinarily would not have a chance to enjoy the summer. Now, I'm a Catskills guy. So is Bernard. So we know about the rivers and the streams and the beautiful green, you know, the softball fields, all that good stuff. Tell folks about this camp, and if, in fact, they need a place for their kid to go, how they can get involved.
Okay. The camp is on about 104 acres up in Taberg, New York. It's a camp that's for children of need, you know, children with special needs. All the kids that go there, their families do not pay a dime to go there. All the Kiwanians around the state, the New York district, sponsor these kids. It's a camp that takes children that are of special needs, whether they be physically needy or economically needy, and we mainstream them all. In other words, we'll have a child in a wheelchair playing with a child running around,
and wow.
It's something that doesn't really happen in many camps. I've been involved with it for 20 years. I've been in Kiwanis 30 years, but 20 years ago we got involved with it, and it's a wonderful place. We call it a magical place. We call it a place where dreams are made.
Wow.
What county is Taborg in?
Taborg is right outside of Rome. It's Oneida County.
Up by your father, baby.
Sure, I know. Right,
yeah. His dad.
Yeah, we go up there many times a year, and we stay at a little bungalow called Turning Stone Hotel.
Well, you stay at a little bungalow. There's a gorgeous casino. That's the bungalow you're talking about. Yeah. That's a gorgeous place.
We used to tell our wives that we have to go and rough it this weekend.
Yeah. It's a gorgeous place.
A great selection of a location for you guys.
Yeah, it's right there.
Just a coincidence, though, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, just a coincidence.
Oh, it is, because they actually built that casino many years after the camp started.
The camp is 50 years old this year. As a matter of fact, back in March of last year, we had a big gala.
Right.
And it's been in the 80s, up until the 80s, it was all boys, and then we made a co-ed.
Oh, nice.
And we have a great executive director, which runs the camp and, you know, develops programs for these kids. We have 6 weeks of children. 2 weeks prior to that, we take 2 weeks of adults from a nearby home, and then 2 weeks after the kids, we kind of really rent it to an organization, Lifestyles for the Disabled. Mm-hmm. They're in Staten Island, but they come up there and they take the camp for 2 weeks, and they've been coming back for the last 5 years and always raving about what we do up there.
All right, so 60 seconds to go. Thank you, Sal and Ellie. Back to Steve Sergiovanni. There's the Kiwanis Club. You guys do great stuff. You have bowling events. You got the softball team. You do all kinds of cool stuff all year. I always remember Knights of Pythias when I was a kid. Were you remember any of those, Columbus, or any of them?
No, he was juvenile.
He was robbing cars, right. why would somebody want to join the Kiwanis Club?
Well, Kiwanis has given back, you know, what was freely given to us.
Right.
You know, is when you see a child that goes to camp, and some of these children, they come with nothing.
Yeah.
And you make a difference in life. You know, we had this one child that came there, and it was a headbanger. His brother was a headbanger, and he never wanted to go home. He didn't want to live that lifestyle.
Right.
You know, when we're at camp, we have an anti-bullying program, teaching about anti-bullying, how to not to pick on people.
Right.
Different functions there, and they want to come back. They want to keep on coming back.
So basically, all you do all year long is really geared towards the camp and making this available for those kids.
Well, a lot of clubs do a lot of different things. Like, we have clubs all over. It's international, first of all.
Right.
And a lot of clubs, like Sal's Clubs, today's having a golf outing.
Nice.
And one of their prizes is three people, and they can play around the golf with Rick Pitino.
How about that?
Yeah. You know,
yeah. This is our biggest fundraiser. We raise anywhere from $70,000 to $100,000, and all that money at the end of the year goes back to the.
And where's this tournament at today? I'm just curious.
Brookdale Country Club. Very nice. In Long Island.
Right, you guys are saints, I got to tell you.
Yeah, they are good people.
Really impressive people.
I when you see the smiles on the kids' faces, it's all worth it.
What do you want to say,
Sid? Okay, Sid, I'm coming in and listening to you all morning. You said about a foundation that you started with your wife.
Yes.
The Howard Beach Kiwanis Foundation would like to donate the first check of $500.
Thank you. You know, you get too much. God, I love you. I love both you guys. Steve Sergiovanni and Sal Anello, both just terrific guys.
Really?
And, you know, you're going to make me cry now.
We thank you for having us and
thank
having
you.
This.
Yeah. We thank you for what you do.
Thank you guys.
Are great.
Thank you.
Yeah, we're looking forward to beating you.
That ain't going to happen. We'll take a short
break. Okay, we'll put a little side bet.
Nice guys finish last.
That's right.
You are nice guys.
Two nice guys.
I hate to lose.
We'll take a short break. We'll come back and wrap things up on the Bernie and Sid in the Morning Show right after these words.
Bernie and Sid in the Morning, 77 WABC.